What's up, guys? Donnie Nodak on my way to Sakakawea. Got a nice overcast day for fishing. Gonna see what happens here. Hopefully we can get into some walleye. We'll let you know here in a little bit. I'll be back once I'm set up. Ladies and gentlemen, see you soon. It's a good spot. So far it's been producing just like now. Good fish on. See what we got. A big old smallmouth. Go figure. On Sakakawea. Sakakawea smallmouth midday. Not huge, but good sized fish nonetheless. But let me tell you guys a story while we're taking this guy off the line. So there's a guy, we won't say last names. We'll go by the first name, Josh. But he hit me up a few weeks back, said, "Hey man, when are you gonna start fishing the big lake?" Which is Sakakawea, for those who don't know what the big lake is. So here I am. I was like, "Okay, yeah, where are you fishing?" He's like, "Oh, I'm over by Wolf Creek." I was like, "Okay, cool." I was like, "Do you have a good mark that you could send me to out there?" So, look at that guy. So anyway, he sends me a mark. I was like, "Yeah, I'll go check that out." I get out there and I can't get out there. It's all broken up, refreeze, and he expected me to drive my truck out there. I was like, "Nah, this isn't gonna work for me." So what do? I do what I always do. And I looked at the Navionics. So, looked at the Navionics and I found a lot of good spots out in that area. So I chose one, started fishing like I always do. And as soon as I dropped in, I caught a 21 inch walleye. Sent him a picture and he's like, "Oh, you ass." So I was like, "Okay, cool, whatever." And getting another mark right now. And he, I fished it. I went home and I got a hub. I went back and I fished literally 72 hours out on this spot. So I hit him up. I was like, "Hey man, I got two limits, or I got a limit. I'm on my way home to clean my fish and head back out there." But I didn't phrase it like, "Oh, you know, I'm heading back out there, you know, to stay out there for 72 hours, which I did in negative 40 degree temps. But I caught a limit that morning. Stayed out. I got back out about 8-9 o'clock at night. I caught another limit at about midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning. Then I stayed out there. I went home and I cleaned that limit like I always do. And then I went back out there for the following evening, didn't catch shit. I caught two fish. That's when I packed up and moved. The next morning I caught two fish. So I packed up and I got out of there because Wolf Creek's not that great, Josh. I hate to tell you, it's okay, but it's not that great. This dude thinks he's like the founder of Wolf Creek and he's the original explorer to find it. Well, that's not the case. Josh, you didn't find Wolf Creek. There's about 300 or 400 other people out there fishing when I was out there. So I don't fish spots like that on the regular. So needless to say, I moved on. Josh, you need to move on. Stop being such a snowflake. Get over yourself, buddy. You didn't found Wolf Creek. You didn't explore it, find it, none of that shit. So believe me, I won't fish it again because it's not that great. I have other spots on Sac that blow that out of the water. So either way, guys, figured I'd put that out there so you know what's going on. I don't keep double limits. Never have, never will. But if you think I do, might as well unsubscribe from my channel because that's not how I roll, ladies and gentlemen. Definitely not how I roll. I catch my limits. Normally, every time I fish, I catch my limit. Yeah, I've been known to keep a few bigger fish, but there's no rules against it. Except for unwritten rules, but anything 24 or bigger, I usually throw back. But just because I don't really like the way they taste. But either way, I'm out here. I'm already catching fish. Just showed up. But I'll keep you guys posted. Let's see how we do today. Done griping. Done venting. That's just all I had to say. One walleye, about 14 inch. Kind of small for what I'm used to keeping, so I'll probably let him go. On to the next one. Let the games begin. About a 9-inch perch. 9-inch perch on a VMC teardrop. Red glow teardrop. On to the next fish. Here we go, 15-inch. 15-inch walleye. I'm going to keep that one. There's two walleye. Another 15. Definitely an eater. Keep going home. See you on the next fish. That's three walleye, four walleye so far today, and a smallmouth and a perch. There you go. There you go. There's three eaters. This is the third one I'm going to take home today. Nice fish. No double limits. No double limits. Just saying. Definitely take that slob perch, 11 inch. Nice size perch. Definitely an eater. Eater number four. Probably 14 and a half inch, give or take. It's definitely 14 inch at least. I'm taking that guy home. One more, I go home. Anyway, y'all, it was a pretty productive day out on Sakakawea. Where I go, it's about a 3.5 mile drive to get there. Out, and then we have to drive around a bunch of reefs and whatever else. But I'm gonna have to say it was a pretty good day. Four walleye in total. I would have had five, but I let one go earlier. Probably the first one I caught this morning, I just let it go because I was expecting some bigger fish later in the day. So that guy got to go back. I should have kept him, but either way, good day. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and please check out all of our channels on Facebook. We've got Nodak Ice Fishing on Facebook, and we've also got Nodak Outdoors. That is all types of fishing, camping, and hunting. That's our new group we just started, so be sure to check that out, and I'll see you guys on the next round. Donnie, Nodak, you guys have a great rest of your day.